Election day is just over a week away, and at this stage in the game, Donald Trump is ahead in the polls. And if you look at the betting market, Donald Trump is miles ahead, 66% to 34% on Polymarket. But if this election campaign has taught us anything, a week is a long time in politics and anything can happen. Nothing is guaranteed. Except, of course, the attacks against Donald Trump. Those are guaranteed to continue.
Donald Trump is increasingly unhinged and unstable.
Let's take a look at some of the coverage from the mainstream media that we've been seeing in recent days, because the left-wing media is having a meltdown over Donald Trump's Madison Square Garden rally.
But my point is, it's discouraging that so many people would gather and rally to hate speech in America, that it's discouraging and it hurts. Oh my gosh. How did we get here? How did we get
here, of course, where
a stadium of people come to hate? That's a different country, a different time.
Hosts from outlets like MSNBC just can't fathom that there are people out there, plenty of them, that want Donald Trump back in the White House, and they turned out in New York City to support him. But it's not just hosts from MSNBC freaking out. How's this take that Whoopi Goldberg is running with? According to her, well, she's figured out what Donald Trump really wants, his big secret agenda. And it's not about deporting people who've come into America illegally. He wants to break up interracial marriages, and then he wants to set up the, quote, white guy with someone else.
Talking about you, it's us. He's not going to say, oh, you're with a white guy, I'm going to keep you from being deported. No, he's going to deport you and put the white guy with someone else. The man is out there.
You know, Donald Trump has spoken at length about his plans to fix the broken immigration system in America, to protect Americans, so we don't have to report that people like Lake and Riley have been murdered at the hands of an illegal immigrant. But Whoopi Goldberg and others can't seem to fathom that either. Now, we know that Kamala Harris has been relying on celebrities from Hollywood to back her in and get votes. And how's the joy that's being spread from actors like Robert De Niro?
It makes me so f***ing angry. That we're here talking about a piece of shit like Donald Trump.
Kamala Harris is doing everything she can to distance herself from President Joe Biden, hoping that there are still a few voters out there that don't know she has been with Joe Biden every step of the way for the past 3.5 years. And unfortunately for Kamala Harris, Joe Biden keeps reminding them.
And I know who was standing next to me the last 4 years, Kamala Harris. Let me tell you something, folks. I picked her because she has a backbone like a ramrod. I'm serious. She's a backbone like a ramrod.
The president cast his vote in Delaware today, and he was asked by reporters if he has plans on linking up with the vice president now that it's crunch time. And he actually admitted that her team told him to stay right away.
I've been on the trail. We talk all the time, and they're asking me to where they think I should be to help them most. I'm going to be in Pennsylvania, going to head to Scranton and a few other places.
Ouch. Now, a number of Americans are voting early in this election, and there's been a drastic uptick in the number of Republicans casting their vote early. Sky News host Paul Murray has given his breakdown of the polls and where Donald Trump is now compared to where he was 4 and 8 years ago.
Well, today, Donald Trump was at Madison Square Garden, which just, that's such a huge thing. The idea that he's able to pull that crowd, that many people, all of those endorsements, this was mega, all right? Absolutely mega. And don't fall for the garbage, oh, it's a Nazi rally for the 1930s. Republicans have been there many times before, conventions, all the rest of it, so just throw that to one side. Harris, in the past couple of days, she found a new accent when she was at a black church. But now, because we're getting close to the day, the media is now having to actually be honest about what's happening here. This was NBC.
But we have seen a number, 4 in the last 4 days, that have shown very small, but in the context of this close race, potentially meaningful movement in Trump's direction.
No! Can you imagine the scream, right? Again, I don't know. You don't know. I've showed you data last night that shows how Harris can get there. Well, the propensity of data is showing how Trump's going to get there. Again, I'll show you this every single night, which is the Real Clear Politics average of all of the polls. Other sites sort of decide and pick and choose, but in all of them, Trump is leading in the battleground states. Now, I wouldn't want to be taking anything to the bank that's 0.2 or 0.5, but the point is he's grossly underperformed the polls in previous times where they just got the number wrong for him. So if he's leading, this could be a massive blowout. Or for some reason, they've overcounted Trump voters and it's going to be a massive blowout for Harris. But I think we know what's happening here. To show you about those national polls, now remember, Trump's never won a national popular vote. Have a look here at the difference between the red lines and the blue lines. That black line in the middle, all of that to the left is before Biden, Trump leading, Trump leading. Then the summer of vibes and the brat summer meant she went up, 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 up. But look what's happened. He's closed the deal, she's fallen off, and now he is in front. In fact, on this very day, 4 years ago, Biden led by 7.5% in the national vote. 8 years ago, on this very day, Clinton led by 4.6%. Back to the MSG rally. Today, Madison Square Garden in New York. There was a comedian, Tony Hinchcliffe. I think he's great when it comes to roasting, but he probably wasn't the great pick to turn out here because he plays a pretty rough game, including jokes that the internet have deemed to be deeply racist, offensive, and an example of why you must not vote for Trump.
I don't know if you guys know this, but there's literally a floating island of garbage in the middle of the ocean right now. Yeah. I think it's called Puerto Rico.
So that'll play out for the next 24 hours, but you've heard the joke as opposed to reading about it in a couple of days' time. For Trump, best part of his speech, this is the closing message. You should say this 1,000 times over the next 8 days.
I'd like to begin by asking a very simple question. Are you better off now than you were 4 years ago? On issue after issue, Kamala broke it. But I will fix it. We're going to fix it.
As for Kamala Harris, now being confronted by the reality that the polling is not what it should be, which is she should be running away with it because she's running against Hitler, well, she proved herself to be the genius that we know her to be.
So, to be very frank with you, my internal polling is my instinct. I let the campaign people deal with the poll, all that other stuff. And I am responding to what I'm seeing. I mean, just two nights ago, we had 30,000 people show up. I think it was actually more than 30,000 people, with an incredible amount of enthusiasm. If you see the people showing up last night, every event that we do, and the feeling is one of energy and excitement.
I'll ask you this question. Who do you think's winning?